And when they came to the crowd, a man came up to him and kneeling before him said, Lord, have mercy on my son, for he is an epileptic and he suffers terribly. For often he falls into the fire and often into the water. And I brought him to your disciples and they could not heal him. And Jesus answered, O faithless and perverse generation, how long am I to be with you? How long am I to bear with you? Bring him here to me. And Jesus rebuked him, and the demon came out of him, and the boy was cured instantly. Then the disciples came to Jesus privately and said, Why could we not cast it out? He said to them, Because of your little faith. For truly I say to you, if you have faith as a grain of mustard seed, you will say to this mountain, Move from here to there, and it will move, and nothing will be impossible to you. Most of us all the time would say, Yes, I believe, I have faith in God. But the problem is that when we start to face difficulties in our lives, like sickness of oneself or any of our beloved ones, or loss of job, or deaths, or any such kind of crisis in our life, we become wary. Very often we fail to apply our professed faith in those moments, and we start to question about the existence of God. We often ask questions like, Does God really exist? Even if He exists, is He really loving me? If He loves me, why this happened in my life? And we tend to live with these doubts and go far away from the presence of God. Finally, we end up in front of many impossibilities. Jesus says in the Gospel, If you have a faith as a grain of mustard seed, you will say to this mountain, Move from here to there, and it will move, and nothing will be impossible to you. He challenges the unbelief of his disciples and tells them that even a small measure of genuine faith can accomplish great things. Now, what is this faith? Hebrews 11:1 gives us a simple and elegant definition of faith. It says, Faith is the assurance of things hoped for and the conviction of things not seen. St. Thomas Aquinas says, Faith is the act of the intellect when it ascends to divine truth under the influence of the will, moved by God through grace. It is clear from these definitions that faith is both divine and human act. We are acting with the power of the grace of God. Deuteronomy 5 confirms that before this faith can be exercised, man must have the grace of God to move and assist him. He must have the interior helps of the Holy Spirit, who moves the heart and converts it to God, who opens the eyes of the mind and makes it easy for all to accept and believe the truth. In other words, we can say that faith is an obedience to the God who gives us this supernatural virtue. In the Old Testament, we see many figures who lived their lives by trusting in the power of God. One major person among them is Abraham, who is known as the father of all believers. He believed in God and trusted him when the things were not in his control. He submitted his will and intellect to God and committed himself without reservation to God's will and saving power. Old Testament teaches us that our strength lies in trusting God, not in ourselves. Only trust and confidence in the Lord will bring the sure hope of safety and salvation. To have this faith, in order to grow in faith, we must cultivate it. We need to pray to God, forgive us the grace of faith. Mother Teresa says, If you will not pray, your faith will leave you. Prayer helps us to grow in faith. It will turn our attention to Jesus, not to ourselves. By praying and reflecting on the Word of God, we will focus on His promises. It will help us to have conviction of things not seen and to ask for the grace to trust in Him. Let us ask Jesus for a deeper faith. Lord, help us set our hearts on things above, to turn to You constantly as the source of all life. May Your Holy Spirit infuse in us the supernatural virtue of faith. May our faith in You help us to think beyond flesh and blood and have a greater trust in You. May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.